The Hollywood Bowl. Rather impressive, isn't it? We've got some impressive new stars on CBS. Let's meet the Incredible Hulk, David Banner, Bill Bixby.
How delightful to welcome back from the Incredible Hulk, Bill William Bixby.
Wilfred, Lita. Wilfred.
Look,
I didn't even ask for that name. My parents gave it to me and I was too small to do anything about it. But it is Wilfred, yes.
You know what's very disarming about that show? When it starts out, the music is so gentle and soft and delicate. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden, we see the mass, the massive Hulk and so forth. It seems incongruous.
But that's where I would disagree with you. Most of us in life start out when we wake up in the morning with one kind of an attitude. But when you are confronted with a day of many attitudes, your own personal rhythm changes too. You may start like Swan Lake, you know, and end like the Tempest. The music, the beauty of it is, it's a man who is seeking peace. That's why I always love the love. They only use a single piano in my character. But as more and more aggravation joins his life, so the music starts as well as we get toward that anxiety, that frustration, which makes him Hulk out.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's
Hulk out.
That's what we call it, hulking out.
Hulking out, I like that. You know, you've tackled some pretty tough subjects. Alcoholism for one, mentally retarded, child beating, hijacking. Mm-hmm. Can you adequately deal with that in an hour?
Oh, I don't think that we've been able to adequately deal with it within the last 10 years of our country's history. As a matter of fact, it seems to have grown in its proportions. So, no. All we can do is try and point a finger at the problem, hope some people will see it in themselves, or see mm-hmm. the problem potentially, and hopefully do something about it before they hurt another human being.
Mm-hmm. So you're really just presenting the material. And
that's what drama is really. And television is really meant to entertain. If you can introduce a message to it, all we're designing, hopefully, there is to provoke a question in the mind of the audience. But the answer lies in the audience itself.
Mm-hmm. You're very generous with your time to strangers. There was an article recently about you in TV Guide talking about you driving around and hand-delivering some of your autographs.
Yes.
Now, but isn't this a drain and a strain when people are at your bill saying, I want your autograph, this and that?
Yes, but it was taken a little bit out of context. What happened in the event of the story that was told at TV Guide was true. We had been shooting until 2 o'clock in the morning. I was on the way home. Now, when neighborhood children come on by, It's very difficult. If your doorbell is ringing all the time, that means even your own home mm-hmm. is not private. That's not right. We all would have to agree that we all are at least entitled to a moment of our own time. So all I've ever told the children in the neighborhood is, look, if you want a picture or something, fine, but please don't disturb my household. Leave a note in the mailbox, leave your address, and I'll see that you get it as I can do it. And I happened to be coming home one night, and I had already signed this group of pictures, and it was just a direct route on the way. Mm. So I said, Jimmy, pull the dressing room over for a second. And I just started putting them in mailboxes. It happens that a family saw me doing it, and they came running out. And it became an event, which is exactly what I was trying to avoid.
Yeah.
In the magazine, it looked like I was going out and going, ringing. It's 3 in the morning, but it is I, Bill Bixby, with a picture of me to give to you, and I know you're going to be thrilled. And I said, now that's going to take that joy away, which is it sort of makes it Christmas for the kids in the neighborhood, because if nothing else, they open up the box, and there's something for them from me,
mm-hmm.
and they took the time to write a letter. So it's a matter of politeness. If they took the time to write, which most children don't,
mm-hmm.
and if they took the time to say please, which most children don't,
mm-hmm.
why not respond?
Mm-hmm. You spend about $650,000 per episode on the Hulk, and you own part of the show, as I understand it. How do you keep those costs down?
You can't. This show is on the road most all the time. We are out. I think we're the most expensive single production since
Battlestar Galactica.
Mm-hmm. Our budget has to be awesome. It's a scope show.
Yeah.
We have to get me into an environment that is so big in nature that the Hulk, when he gets into it, we just finished doing one with a Brahma bull where I'm crushed and being stepped on. I believe, don't ever try it.
Everybody in Nebraska rides those.
How do you keep from hulking out? They have to put me into an environment that gives such danger
mm-hmm.
and such a visual surrounding of uniqueness. And as a result, it's just very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
My maximum work week last year was 80 hours. and I think my minimum work week was 65, and I got down to 138 pounds after I did my interview with you.
Mm-hmm.
It just was downhill from there. Brenda and I used to visit on television. I would watch her show, she would watch mine. That's the only time we could get together.
This is his wife. How delightful to meet you.
This
Brenda Binet,
partner.
Wife and partner, and mother of your son, right? Now, you are an only child.
Yes, I am.
And you have an only child.
Yes.
Okay, I want to know about the disciplinary problems in coping with an only child. When the child says, I don't want to go to bed right now, how do you handle it, Brenda?
Well, if it's bedtime, it's bedtime. I mean, it's not a question of whether he wants to or not. I mean, we have a particular rhythm in our household, and especially if it's a school night. That's just the way it is. Now, he doesn't have to go to sleep right away, but still, I mean, there are certain things that we try to have some kind of consistency just in order to keep our own sanity, you know?
Brenda does a marvelous thing, though, that she did early and taught me to use with Christopher, which is if he doesn't want to do something that he is supposed to do, we always give him a choice. All right, you can go to bed now and have so-and-so that you are depending upon, or you can not go to bed now and this will be the result. What would you like to do? Well, good night. if you really frame it right, you know, and it's going to come after a while. I know there's going to come a time when he's going to go, how long have you been pulling this trick on me? But it works very well because if they have a choice, they feel they have some control over their own life.
You're on a television series now yourself.
Yes, I am. Days of Our Life.
Wow. The problems of... Bill's a superstar. We got to admit that. Okay, he's one of the big boys there now.
Yeah.
That's fraught with problems, isn't it, for you?
No, I don't quite understand how. I mean...
Maybe it's not fraught with problems. You don't understand what I mean.
No, no.
Everybody's at him all the time. They want Bill Bixby, the star. How does it make you feel?
Well, I see Bill as the person, and I've known him for 18 years, so it goes along with the job. But we still have our time. There's no competitiveness there. You know, it's really perfectly understandable. I you know, when someone says to me, "Gosh, he's so neat," and I said, "Yes,
yes, he is." I can tell from personal experience. Yes. Well, best of luck to you in your series. It's Days of Our Lives.
Yes,
Days of Our Lives. And, of course, The Incredible Hulk continues with Lou Ferrigno and Bill Bixby. And you know what happens when he gets angry.
In the eyes.
So you better watch right here on 10-11 Strong, where we're looking good.
Looking good. Mm-hmm.